Today, let's try to understand how to compare batteries across different devices. Today's mobile phones are being fitted with bigger and bigger batteries. So you might have come across a mobile phone battery whose milliamp hour rating is much higher than that of your laptop's battery. And you might have wondered, is this possible? As you can see on the screen, the Asus ROG Phone 2 has a 6000 mAh battery, but the MacBook Air 2018 has only 4381 mAh battery. Does this mean the MacBook Air's battery is smaller than that of the Asus ROG Phone 2's battery? The answer is no. Let's dig deeper and try to understand why. The mAh rating of a battery, also called the charge rating, does not indicate the total energy the battery can produce. The total energy is actually given by the product of the charge rating in mAh and the output voltage of the battery. When comparing mobile phone batteries, we generally use only the mAh rating and we don't talk about the output voltage simply because most mobile phones today have the same nominal output voltage of 3.8 volts. Since both phones being compared have the same output voltage, the total energy produced by the battery depends only on the mAh rating. The scenario changes when you try to compare a mobile phone battery with that of a laptop battery, simply because the output voltage of a laptop battery will almost always be higher than that of a mobile phone battery. In this case, using just the mAh rating to compare batteries is no longer valid because the output voltages are different. You have to multiply the charge rating in mAh with that of the output voltage of the batteries to find out the total energy the battery is capable of producing. As you can see, the Asus ROG Phone 2 has a 23.1 watt-hour battery and the MacBook Air has a 56.7 watt-hour battery. So, going back to our previous question, the MacBook Air's battery is 2.45 times bigger than the Asus ROG Phone 2's battery. The mAh rating of a battery could be deceiving when you're comparing batteries with different output voltages, and I hope this example helped you understand that. Let's look at a quick analogy to visualize the charge rating and the output voltage of the battery. Consider two water tanks feeding water to two separate water turbines using identical water pipes. The energy produced by the water turbine depends upon the quantity of water flowing through the turbine and the pressure of the water. Due to the presence of gravity, as the height of the water tank increases above the ground level, the pressure of the water increases. Now assume both the water tanks A and B have 10 gallons of water each. The quantity of water in the tank represents the charge rating of the battery, and the height of the water tank above the ground level represents the output voltage of the battery. Although both the water tanks A and B have the same amount of water in them, water tank B will produce more energy simply because the water flowing out of it has higher pressure. Think about this analogy next time when you come across two batteries with different output voltages. Similarly, we can visualize two mobile phone batteries having the same output voltage as two water tanks at the same height above the ground level. The water pressure of both the tanks will be identical since they're at the same height. As a result, the total energy produced by the turbines depends only on the quantity of water in the tanks, or in other words, the charge rating or the mAh rating. Here are some quick tips while comparing batteries. I'll soon make a separate video on how to easily find the output voltage, the charge rating, and the energy rating of all your Apple devices, Android devices, and Windows devices. Make sure to watch out for that video. If you have any questions or suggestions about our discussion, make sure to leave a comment. And if you think you learned something new, make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.